So here's the reducer code. Let's step through it. We'll start by setting up a couple of variables. Sales total, which will keep the running total, is initialized to zero. Because we haven't read any keys yet, old key starts at none. Then we start reading from standard input. As with the mappers, we receive a line at a time that's tab delimited. In this case, we expect a store name, a tab, and one of the sales. So we'll strip off the new line, separate the value and the key by tab. That should give us two items which we'll store in an array called data. If we don't have two items, something strange has happened, so we'll skip that line. But that should never be the case because we know that mappers send us the data in this format. For the sake of clarity, we'll store the two items in the array into variables. This key will get the store name, this sale, the value. So here's the tricky part. We want to know if the key has changed since the last row we read. So we'll check if old key is even set, because if it's not, then this is the first line we're reading. And if it is, we'll see if it's different to the key we just read in. If that's true, then the key has just changed. In our example data, we had just switched from the Miami row to the New York City row. So now we need to write out the result, which will be key, which is the store name, a tab, and the sales total for that store. Then we reset sales total back to zero. Now for every row that we process, we'll set old key to the key we're working on, then add the current sale to the running total. And then we'll loop back to the next row. Eventually, we'll run out of data, which will take us out of the loop. Do you think we're done?